Hey guys, welcome back to RK Tutors. In this video, I will walk you through how to render housing elevations in Photoshop from an AutoCAD drawing. And we are going to render it in a simple and an elegant way possible in Photoshop. So in this AutoCAD drawing, I have these elevations for a housing project. And as you see, this project follows very typical sort of floor plan. And what I've done here, I've actually applied some solid hatches onto this elevation. So if I just copy one of these units and explode, and if I just select this solid hatch, you will see I have applied some true colors onto these hatches. And that way, when we actually plot the drawing, the same true colors will show. I'm gonna exit from here and delete this group. And before I plot these elevations, I'm also going to remove these human and tree objects. So select them and erase them from both elevations. And then go to plot command. I'm gonna save this to DWG to PDF, keeping the paper size ISO full blade A1 and keeping the window selection for both of these elevations. And I'm gonna go ahead and click on preview to see how it looks. And as you see all these colors, the true colors are visible in this drawing. And I'm going to plot this into a PDF, and to do that, I'll go ahead and click on plot and click on save. And from here, I'm going to right click on this file and open it with Photoshop and crop it to Artbox so we get the exact size of the paper from the drawing, and also setting the resolution to 300. Click on OK to open this. And before we begin rendering this, I'll create a new layer that'll be our background layer. I'm gonna call this background and go to fill option, use a shortcut shift plus backspace to go to fill, and I'm going to keep the background color to white and press OK to apply this. And for this tutorial, I'm also going to crop this into one elevation by choosing the crop tool and crop one of these elevations out. I think this is good, and press enter to apply this. So that way we have one elevation left. First of all, to create the sky, I'm going to create another layer for this. Click on this create a new layer option. Let's call this sky, and also go to rectangular selection tool and make a selection right here. So I think this is good. And what I want to do is basically apply a gradient on this, but first I'm going to fill this with white color. So go to fill command, use the shortcut shift plus backspace and fill the white color on this, press OK, and then double click on this layer to go to layer styles. So click here to actually enable the gradient overlay. We see this gradient is also visible from these housing units. We'll fix that later. But for now, what I'm going to do is basically change the direction, or basically the angle for this gradient. And I'm going to set this on 270. And let's also change the color of this gradient. Go ahead and click on this gradient box. And from here, I'm going to select the very first color and I'm going to change it to something close to blue. I think this is good enough, and click on OK to apply this. And I'm also going to change the scale a little bit of this gradient. I think this is fine, and click on OK to apply this. And next, what I'm going to do is basically go to this drawing layer. Let's also rename this DWG. And from here, I'm going to make the selection of only the elevation. Using the magic wand tool, you can select it from here, or you can also press the shortcut W to go to magic wand tool and click on drawing to make the selection. And from here, right click on this and inverse this selection. And now I also have some of the part from the text selected, and to deselect this, I'm going to use rectangular selection tool or hit the shortcut M to go to this tool and using the Alt key, you can subtract this selection. I'm going to do it for all the text. And after this is done, go to this sky layer and hit delete. And that way we have all this selection removed from this layer that was part of this elevation. And now we can deselect this, use the shortcut Ctrl plus D. And now before we add clouds to this sky, I'm going to crop this image from the top and the bottom, keeping the proportions same, and press enter to apply. And now we can go ahead and add some clouds to this sky. And to do that, I'm going to create a new layer onto this. Let's call this clouds. And you can add all those clouds using the brush tool. But for that, you're gonna need to have different presets for clouds. You can download them from the internet, or you can also click on the link provided in the description to download all these cloud presets. So in this brush tool, we have some cloud presets. I'm gonna go and select one of these. Let's go with this one, resize the brush, and I'm going to keep the color to white and click here. And as you see, this looks really natural. You can also adjust the opacity of this layer and use different cloud presets to add more variation. Let's change the scale a little bit, and I'm going to apply it around here, and it does give a good effect onto this render. So I think this is enough, and I'm going to set the opacity to 80%. And next, let's apply some gradient at the bottom near this ground line. And to add that gradient, I'm simply just going to create another layer and go to brush tool, this time using a soft spherical brush, and also change the size of this. Let's zoom in onto this elevation and select the black color. And before we apply this brush, make this selection a rectangular selection around here. And now use this brush tool, let's change the size a little bit and apply it around here. So hold the shift key so you get the exact horizontal line, and press Ctrl plus D to deselect everything. And from here, I'm going to change its opacity. Let's keep it to 50%, or maybe change it to 20%. So that looks better. And at last, we can add some more details onto this elevation, like trees or human objects. So I'm going to copy some objects from another file. In this file, I have a couple of trees and some human beings. These are just PNGs of this elevation of trees and human beings. So I'm going to select these trees and drag them onto our file. Let's put them in a group, or basically a folder, and place this on the top. Let's call these trees. Let me just zoom in. And as you see here, we can actually refine this gray layer. Select this layer, and I'm going to erase some part of this from here. So that looks better. And select one of these trees and place it right here. And another tree on this side. And now also drag one of the human objects. Let's drag this one and paste it around here, under this tilt. I think that's good. And same way, drag another object. Maybe I'll drag this one and paste this onto our file, and maybe around here. I think this is good enough. And I'll also make another copy of this tree onto opposite side. Let's keep it here. So this is one way to render housing elevations in Photoshop, and later you can export this into different formats for printing or presentation. So that's it for this Photoshop tutorial, and you can check out more Photoshop tutorials from our playlist. So if you like this tutorial, make sure you click on the like button, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell icon for all the latest updates. We'll be right back.